Okay, I'm back again. Let's hope, you know, I get a little more storage on here. You know, it's I did delete some apps that I didn't need, and hopefully that's gonna help me get through this video. Again, this is Ken Obasi Leslie, your painting with Obasi. I'm here Friday night. I'm in my studio. As you can see, there's Sebastian's up there, you know, waiting patiently for me to do my thing. And right now, I'm working on this this piece here. It's kind of like I call it a semi-portrait, but it's really not a portrait of anybody in particular. But I'm kind of working on it, you know, to help, you know, to help show you how to, you know, deal with colors and light and, you know, and all that. In the background, I got a, you know, a little music going. It's a little chaotic right now, but hey, you know, it's, you know, that's the way I love it. this piece is, again, I'm playing Pharoah Sanders. Tahi is, this album is, I guess, done back in 1966, somewhere around in that year circa. And you know, and the pieces that this I'm doing is, one was Japan. Well, actually I'm doing Venus and Capricorn Rising. So, you know, enjoy the music. And here I go, I'm gonna get right into working on this piece. What I had previously done was I gave it a solid background, which it didn't have that background. I gave it that background to be able to bring out the face a little bit, and you know, to kind of, you know, so that we could see, you know, what we need to see, you know, in terms of working with this image. You know, what I have here is, you know, and the medium that I'm working with is oil pastel. But actually, I had started with just regular pastels. You know, actually, I started this piece some years back. But, you know, like a lot of times what I might do is just kind of go ahead and dig out a piece that I have been working on and go from there, you know, because, you know, to me, art or alchemy or whatever you want to call it, you know, it's a process of change through ideas and through inspiration, and colors and sound. Colors are vibration, you know, so therefore, you know, it's just depending on how you use the color, where you use the color, you know, you could create a totally different vibration. So with this orange, I'm going to, you know, give it a little bit of, I'm gonna, you know, use some of this orange to kind of highlight that. I mean, because there's different things that I've already done to it, but I find that, you know, as I use, you know, certain colors, start to to bring things out a little bit more. And you know, and to start to accentuate on certain things. You know, it's just like earlier, I had worked with the eyebrows and everything. And you see, now this is a darker orange that I'm gonna be working with. And I'm gonna go ahead and it has a little bit more red in this orange, you know. But again, you know, it's just that I'm going to use this to start bringing out what I need to bring out. Yeah. And as you can see, again, I love working very spontaneously, because once you get a pretty good image going and everything, it's not really about you messing up, you know. I mean, you know, it's just that alchemy is transmutation, and you know, and it really comes down to change, you know. It comes down to creating a different look or a different deepness, you know, or a different level of perception, you know. And you know, it's just that you know, you create that different level of perception, I'm losing some of my colors. And then before you know it, you know, it's just that, like, you did something that you didn't really set out to do, but it just suddenly became something else, you know? It just starts to grow into a different kind of entity. You know, but you know, it's just that, but it's always, you know, one of the things is always good to be able to work with a medium, no matter what, whether it's art or music or anything that, you know, that you could like open up and go deep inside and get in touch with that flow. I mean, you know, it's just that, in a sense, you know, that they call it zero point, that point where, you know, it's beyond the mind, it's beyond thinking, you know, it's just the expression of like, oh, okay, something tells me to do this, and something tells me to that, and that's the best part of creation, you know, because creation is really beyond our mental matrix, you know, is beyond that level of basically what we have been taught, you know. Here I am is a flesh color that I'm going to implement here. Basically I'm going to try to now put some of that on the top of the lip here. And do as much as I can to shape the lip, because I sort of noticed that there was a I love working with all types of mediums and all types of shapes and all types of flows. A lot of times I just don't find myself sticking with one type of flow. Tomorrow, you might see me doing assemblage. I love working with collage. I find collage to be a very interesting medium. And, it's just that just depends on which way the spirit is flowing at that time. For me, when I come into the studio, it's just that, I may pick that particular medium, but working, it's just that, like, I had years ago, for a while I had worked with pastels, and again, I find pastels to be a very interesting medium, in terms of because a lot of times pastels remind me of sculpture or whatever, or you could take them and start doing your, and right here I'm putting a little white in certain areas, which actually starts to bring out a little bit. As you can see. And okay. And so far I got that going in terms of the use of white. I'm gonna put a little bit more music on, and you can see where I need to work on the mouth a little bit. And of course, we could, that's all in the process of the artwork. Now, what I just put on now is one of my favorite trumpet players from the back. His name is Kenny Dorham, and this is called Afro-Cuban. You know, and actually on this is J.J. Johnson and Cecil Payne, Horace Silver on piano, Oscar Pettiford on bass, Carlos Valdez, Art Blakey on drums, and this is called Aphrodisia, you know, and this piece is, it was done back in the, I would say probably 1954-ish, somewhere around in there, but it's a masterpiece, you know, in terms of music, you know, and in terms of the music you might want to use in while you're doing an art piece, you know, but yeah, you know that. I almost forgot. I have a. Got my little iced coffee here. You know, it's that. I'm a coffee person. I'm telling you. You know, I love my coffee. You know, I mean, you know, it's. I think that at certain point, you know, I'm gonna need to cut down a little bit. You know, but thus far it's been good to me. You know, and I'm gonna definitely be good to it. You know, so, but here's a little, my iced coffee kind of perks me up there. And, yeah, so, yeah, I mean, you know, and working with pastels, as I said, that they are great in terms of, you know, giving you, you know, process of layering, and actually working with pastels is really good at learning how to paint and learning how to, because you know it's just that you can learn how colors work with each other, and. You know, it's just that, now I'm gonna, you know, I'm looking at that. I need a little bit more white on the edges here, you know, and, I see Sebastian's is really ready to help me out, but, and you know, and because of the fact that I put this on a on paper, you know, more or less, and you know, and I'm trying to work with this with the on the easel, so I can show it to you. I mean, you know, it's not the best idea. That, but you know, hey, we do what we can, you know, and yeah. So now, as I can see, now you know, I mean, what you're looking at. Here we go with a little brown, putting that at the edge of the lips, and. And maybe I'll bring the teeth out a little bit. Put this as a shadow down. Now, you know, and actually, and as you can see what I'm doing here. I got that brown going a little bit. Yeah. Get that you know, put a little more shadow and color in there. And now, you know, one of the things that I had problems with is getting the lips right, but you know, still we're gonna work on that. And but you know, basically, as you can see, how things are coming a little more white up in here. Put a little more white down. And, you know, but we're gonna work with those lips and work with the mouth a little bit. But, you know, again, you can see how I'm dealing with the colors, you know. Now, you know, it's just that, you know, working with pastel again is really fun to work with. You know, it's just a matter of, now, you know, some of the other pieces that I'm going to show you something here. You know, I'll show you that, you know, there are many different ways to work with, you know, different styles. This is something I did years ago with ink, but, you know, it's dealing with like little points. And you know, actually, they had called this is a piece I'm still going to be working on, and they, you know, at one point in time called it like pointillism, you know, or I guess you still call it pointillism or whatever. But I had like worked on, and here's another piece that I did in the same way, you know, to give it that pointillism. But these are some of the things that I will be working with you a little later, you know, show you how to, you know, get that going. And you know, this is it. And just to show you another piece that I will be, this is actually a painting I'm working with, you know, with the colors and everything, you know, so we will get to this a little later in terms of, you know, what I'm, you know, to get it shaped up and everything, you know. It's just that, but this is just like one of the things I'm working with. Actually, this is done on a window, you know. I mean, you know, I like working in all types of mediums, all types of, what you might even say, a canvas or whatever. But this is actually a window. And so, you know, for years I've painted on windows, you know, so it's just kind of like, I'll tell you that story. And again, you know, you're with Ken Obasi Leslie. You're in my studio. One of the things I felt in my heart that, you know, I wanted to get back to my studio. Life takes you through a lot of different things, and you know, and you have to do what you got to do, and in order to you know, get what you want or survive, let's put it that way, you know. But one of the